Hey, what's up guys? And yeah, sit back and relax and check out a brand new series. What if Naruto was banished and became the strongest demon lord? The world is gonna be a bit different, but not too far away from the original canon. But it's gonna have a few different things in it. But it's gonna be awesome, so place your feet up, sit back, relax, and I hope you guys enjoy. And don't forget to go ahead and check out the new channel, guys. Anime Symbol. I already have a poll up for you guys to enjoy. The what ifs that I'm taking directly from you. So if you want to see your what ifs done, go over there and check it out, guys. And the other links for the other channels will be down in the description. So yeah, without further ado, or wasting any more time, what do you say we jump right into this brand new what if? Let's begin now, guys. You can't be serious. A voice spoke with utter rage as he slammed his fist down on the table, cracking it. You're suggesting that I send my eldest daughter into the hands of a demon. This is an outrage. She's supposed to be my heir. Hayashi Hayuga spoke in rage. You have another daughter, the elder of the Hayuga said. And from what we have seen, the younger one is a better child. Hinata does not meet the requirement to be the next clan head in your place. He's correct. Another elder spoke up. Or would you rather have the cage bird seal placed on one of them, the elder asked, looking down towards Hayashi. Hayashi growled as he nursed his hand that he just bruised up. Still, the very idea of that monster taking my child is, we know. The elder said in sympathy, the third one to speak. No one should lose a child like this, Hayashi, but the vote was unanimous amongst the clans, and the Hayuga clan must give up their eldest child to please the demon lord. Otherwise, these attacks might never come to an end. Hayashi frowned as he sat down in his chair. We are a ninja village. Military tacticians run deep in our roots, and yet we cannot stop these few demons. He shook his head in anger and also sadness. I pray that Kami will take mercy on my daughter. Send word to the Hokage that I will escort Lady Hinata in the morning. All I ask is to spend one more night with my daughters as a family. We will do that. The elder spoke sadly, knowing the weight of this decision that was placed on Hayashi's shoulders. As Hayashi rose once more as he ran a hand down his face. How am I supposed to tell my daughters that they must say their goodbyes? Time skip. A few hours later, two young women, one a 15-year-old girl, wearing a lavender kimono with silver moon patterns on it, the other one a 10-year-old, wearing a similar kimono except it had small burst of fireworks on it. The both of them were stunned to what they just heard. The oldest, Hinata, spoke as she cast her gaze down. I see. I'll do what you say, father, she said. What? Her younger sister cried as she got up to her feet. Why? Why does she have to go? We have no choice, my dear, Hayashi said with a tired sigh. Do not think I did this without conscience. We are one of the last noble families in the Leaf aside from the Kurama and Uchiha clans. It falls on us to make this tide. Hanabi was not convinced though. You just want her gone so she doesn't have to be branded. Hanabi! Hayashi spoke up as he raised his tone, causing her to quiet down. He then sighed as he looked at her. Yes, one reason I am sending her is because, due to her clan laws, she would have to be sealed, while you will ascend as clan head. Call me a fool, but I cannot watch one of my precious daughters be sealed by such a cruel, wretched curse mark. You think making her the bride of the demon is any better? Hanabi asked with tears streaming down her face. Hinata reached out as she hugged her. It's fine, Hanabi, she said. Perhaps this demon lord is kind. She tried to reassure her sister. As her father spoke, though I do not know much about him, it said that he was birthed here within the village from the previous demon lord before she passed away. I knew her to be a kind woman, perhaps. He is like her, as you say. Time skip. Across the land of fire. And they believe this to be my fault. Just because those demons are looking for food. A young man asks to a white-haired individual. The old white-haired man shrugged. People always try to place blame when they can't. Take it themselves, kid. You know that. The young man was 16 years old. With two spiky blonde bangs that came down into his face. As they were at the side, pulled back so they would not obscure his vision. His eyes were slitted like a fox. With a bright, brilliant blue, he was wearing a red and black yukata. On his hip there was a black, sheathed sword with red stripes going around it. The child sighed. I really don't see how sending me a woman is going to call off the attacks. I much prefer if they left me alone. Can't you do something to stop them, Purvis H? He asks. Nothing is going to stop them, Jiraiya said, huffing at the nickname for a bit. He then grinned. Besides, I bet they picked the most beautifulest girl to send to you. Just picture it, he said. A lovely young thing. Before he could go into his thoughts, Naruto cut him off. Okay, that's enough, he said. The last thing I need is a woman running around here, especially with those damn spasms coming so frequently now. It will be dangerous for her. Jiraiya sighed. You don't need to worry about that, Naruto, he said. You know I gave her father my word that I would help you with the fox. And I appreciate that, said Naruto. However, it's still getting harder and harder for me to fight him. I'm surprised I lasted this long. I have tried to reason with him, but he just will not listen to me. As Jiraiya sighed when he heard that, you have not been drawing on his chakra, so he must be trying to force you to do so. But you know you don't have to worry about that. As long as you keep him at bay, there's nothing that he can do to hurt you. You've been keeping up with your sage training, haven't you? Of course, said Naruto. But keeping myself from feeling rage and hate is hard enough without that damn fox at every turn, reminding me that I was forced into this, and that I will never be accepted by normal people, ninja or not. This girl will probably be the same. As Jiraiya nodded in understanding, the Ninetale is the strongest of all demons. But your mother once told me that it could be tamed by love. How? I do not know. But she had faith in you otherwise. She wouldn't have allowed the demon to be sealed inside of you. The boy simply sighed as he stepped down the hall. The massive Shiro Castle that was his home still amazed him at times. There was nothing that he lacked for. Once a year, things were sent to him. Food, silk, gold, jewelry, for the most part. Even a few animals that he released in the wild surrounding the castle. The only thing that he really lacked for was human company. His godfather had been with him for most of his life, but that was all expected for a few short visits from the old sage teammate, Snevy. Now that he thought it over, maybe it wouldn't be so bad to have someone else here. When will she be arriving? That was if she accepted everything, though. Jiraiya shrugged. We are far away from Land of Fire. Our little island is about a week worth trip all around. And that is if the person is coming on foot. That's a 2-day trip across the bay, if the traveler don't get caught in the whirlpools. It's already been 7 days since I got wind of the arrival, so it should be any day now. As Naruto sighed as he looked through the window, glancing over the island, the village, the ruins of the hidden Eddy village, the reminder of what he had lost during the second war. It had once been a rich little island that his clan had resided on in the olden days. Now the once proud village was nothing but rubble. How I wish I could rebuild my home. We will need a lot of support for that, kid. But it's a wonderful dream. As Naruto looked back out. Look, Naruto, don't be so down about the village or the girl. In fact, she can turn out to be a blessing. If her family are rich, then perhaps she can help you build a new village. One that you can rule over as a good man. Naruto smiled at that thought. Maybe, he said. His eyes then went towards the sea as he saw something on the horizon. I don't believe it, he said. Jiraiya stepped up next to him as he glanced out. As he saw. Well, that's not good, he said. Looks like they're having some bad luck with the whirlpools. Naruto sighed. Better get out there, Pervis H, he said. Or else, they might not make it. Meanwhile, is it really like this always out here? Hayashi asked as he tried to keep his foot on the deck of the ship. The whirlpools that surround the ship were too small to pose a big of a threat, but the ride was not easy in the slightest. Afraid so, Lord Hayuga. It is a treacherous journey across the bay, the captain said to him. Down below, a young woman was trying to keep her stomach calm as she tried to keep herself settled until the ship lurched and she was sent tumbling forward. Hinata groaned as she picked herself up as she looked around. Hanabi, are you alright? The door to her cabin opened up as her sister came in, barely able to keep her foot steady. Sis, I don't like this, she said. Hinata knelt so that she could steady her. It's gonna be fine, Hanabi, you'll see, she said. Hanabi still looked frightened though. Is the demon lord doing this, she asked. No, Hinata said quickly. This is a land of whirling tides. So they're natural whirlpools, but they're small. They won't hurt the ship. I hope, she thought to herself, not saying the final part out loud. However, soon there was a shout of the word maelstrom. Hanabi was confused as her sister stiffened. What's a maelstrom? Nothing, Hinata whispered. As she held on to her sister, it's nothing at all. Hanabi could hear her sister heart quicken. She was lying to her. But Hinata knew it. A maelstrom was a monstrous whirlpool. No ship could survive it. Hanabi shook with fear as she was now panicking even more than before. Above deck, Hayashi was feeling the same fear. The whirlpool was monstrous. Twice the size of their ship. Kami, please help us, he said. As that was followed by a laugh. Ask not Kami for help, but the great and powerful Toad Sage of Mount Miyaboku. A boisterous voice shouted out. Hayashi looked up to see a tongue shooting towards the ship. What the? As he saw a massive toad on the shore. Bring them in, Bunta, Jiraiya said. Stop yelling in my ear, the toad said to him. As the ship lurched forward, Hayashi, almost falling over. What's going on, Hayashi said. What is the meaning of this? The toad glared at him for the remark. You want me to put you back in the water, he asked. On top of the toad stood Jiraiya. Oh, I wouldn't upset Yamabunta. He has a really bad temper, worse than many of the women I know. He cackled at the ship near the shore and the toad's massive mouth. Wait, don't let him eat us, Hayashi said. Tah, Yamabunta spat. The last time I ate a human, I got heartburn for a week. And I still have that bad taste in my mouth. As he placed the ship down, maybe you just miss a bit of him in your teeth. Jiraiya joke. The toad glanced up towards him. Moron, I don't have any teeth, he said. As Jiraiya cackled once more before he leaped, going straight down towards that ship. As the people watched on the deck in amazement as Jiraiya landed, cracking the wood slightly. Thank the heavens for your good fortune, people. Because you had the pleasure of being rescued by the great Toad Sage of Mount Miyaboku. The dashing hero who has women swooning and falling at his feet as he strike a pose. Yes, I am the gallant Jiraiya, he said. With a big, tooty smile and his pose set in. Even the waves seem to stop for a moment as he finishes his introduction. Gamabunta sighs, a hand covering his face. How the hell did I get stuck with this guy? Gamabunta asks himself. As he looked down towards the people of the ship. What the old pervert is trying to say is, we mean you no harm. As Hayashi recognized the sage from the history books, to be one of the three Sanins of the Hidden Leaf Village. The island master sent us out here to help once he saw that maelstrom forming. You really should have done your research before coming out here. It's high tide, and when that happened, the whirlpools get huge and violent, the toad explained. Shaking his head out of the shock, Hayashi turned towards the toad. I am in your debt for saving the ship, Lord Yamagunta, and your summoner, Master Jiraiya, he said. So, you have heard of me, said Jiraiya. Only because you were such a loudmouth in your youth, said Yamagunta as he pulled out a pipe. So, are you here to see the Lord of the Island? We are, Hayashi said. Is it possible that we speak to him? It is, Jiraiya said. But know that he's a bit skeptical about this whole arrangement. He's not the most sociable of people. I understand, Hayashi said. We will meet with him at his discretion. My daughters are rather nervous about this. Though, he is civil, isn't he? Hayashi asked as he looked at Jiraiya. He's as civil as the next person, Jiraiya said. He's simply unused to people visiting him on this island. Being banished and all, you understand. Oh, of course, Hayashi said, stuttering. My apologies. I am merely as nervous as my daughters. I've never been in the presence of a summon, such as a creature as Lord Yamagunta. The toad and Sanin shared a laugh. Well, you and your daughters are about to be in the presence of a very, very powerful man, even without the demon's power. While that was going on, Naruto stood at the balcony of his castle as he watched the scene down below play out. As the people made their way towards Yamagunta head as he started to trek towards the castle. As Naruto made his way down, preparing to meet his very first guest since Sneda last visited. Time skip. Hinata was shocked to see the castle. It was well known that demon lords were isolated, but she hadn't realized just how much. As she crossed over a bridge, several sakura trees were on each side. However, they have long since bloomed their last though. When the spring came again, she knew the land would be beautiful when the trees bloom. As Jiraiya led them, he stopped at a large gate and gave the double doors a push. They swung right open without much resistance. As Jiraiya grinned over his shoulder at them, not bad for a 55-year-old geezer, huh? Hanabi giggled beside her sister. He's funny, she said. The castle was now within reach. Hinata started to become a whole lot nervous as her breathing started to quicken. All too soon they stood at the castle doors as Jiraiya led them inside. Please don't touch any of the artwork. Lord Naruto did many of the paintings himself, and he's very protective of them. It turns out the paintings were massive portraits. It was of the nine-tailed fox itself. Many, much to the fear of Hanabi, was of the fox, destroying battles with his massive fiery breath. A portrait caught Hinata's attention. This one seemed special, as it was a nine-tailed fox. On top of his head was Madara Uchiha, facing down Senju Hashirama, the first Hokage of the Hidden Leaf. Jiraiya caught her eye. It's his way of passing time. And for why they all portray the fox, it's because he keep the fox calm while he put detail into his work. They are magnificent, Hayashi said. Such detail is unheard of when portraying one of the nine demons. Has he seen it? Jiraiya turned towards him. It haunts him. It's only because he has tried to reason with the beasts that he has not cut the link with the seal, blocking the fox voice out of his mind. There were no more questions after that was said, as they were led inside of what seemed to be a throne room. As Hinata finally saw someone, He was as tall as her father. However, he was wearing a face mask that concealed the upper half of his face, only showing his lower half. Simply being near him, they could feel an ominous presence coming from him. It was almost like they were a dwarf in everything. It was a sense of power. High as she approached, Hinata and Hanabi side by side him as he went to one knee. So did the girls, following in his step. As Jiraiya stepped up to the right side, standing there, presenting Lord Naruto Uzumaki of the Whirling Castle, Demon Lord of the Nine Tails, and Master of Sealing Arts. He then gestured towards them. My lord, may I present Lord Hayashi, clan leader of the Hyuga clan in the village of the Hidden Leaf, and his two daughters. Raise your heads. Hinata blinked surprised as they did. His voice. It was not what she expected. It sounded so small. I am told that you bring a daughter of your house in hopes of quelling recent attacks on your village. Hayashi nodded. We have, my lord. Many of the villagers believe that you will be able to help us. Well, you are wrong, said Naruto. The demons don't listen to me any more than a nine-tailed fox does. What makes you think I had anything to do with these lower-class demons? Hayashi frowned. Because they're foxes, my lord, and we only know of one demon lord amongst the fox tribe. The Ninetales, said Naruto. He spoke internally. Tell me, fox, do you have something to do with these attacks? A deep rumbling spoke up in the back of his mind, almost like it was laughing at him. Well, well, well. The brat decided to take initiative and speak to his prisoner. Though it is of little concern of yours, the fox clan of the world, they all look to me as their leader. Without my rule, they run wild, as foxes tend to do. However, if they invade a village, it would not be for no reason. We do not mingle ourselves with humans. Unnecessary. Your kind must have done something to upset them. How so? Said Naruto. I was only in the village long enough to learn how to take care of myself. You would have known the village layout better than me. Indeed I do. As a matter of fact, not far away from the outskirts of the village walls, there once stood a great shrine to Lady Ineri, my once wife, and a great leader among us. Ask if the shrine still stands. Naruto turned his gaze. Outside the village walls, there stood a shrine of the goddess Ineri. Does it still stand? He asked. Hayashi flinched slightly. He sighed. I know of the shrine. And no, it no longer stands. Some months ago, before the attack started, a group of ninjas attempted to infiltrate the village, where resistance met them. The shrine was caught up in the crossfire between the two opposing forces, and it was destroyed. The fox laughed in his head. Oh, this just keep on getting better and better, brat. That shrine was sacred to my people, and if it has been destroyed, they won't stop until they're wiped out or the shrine is rebuilt, or maybe not even then. A frown grew on Naruto's face. This is not good. My lord, Hayashi asked, as Naruto stepped down, getting closer. The shrine must be rebuilt, he said. Though, I do not know if the attacks will stop. It may please them enough for them to listen to reason and make peace, though. Hayashi stood, showing that he had a bit more height over the boy in front of him. You are certain this will lessen the attacks? Perhaps, said Naruto, as he glanced towards the two girls. Now, regarding your daughter, please, Hayashi said, interrupting Naruto. My lord, you must understand, my clan is harsh to those who are weak. When the main branch of the family produces two ears, one must be branded with a mark of servitude. The eye area of Naruto's mask lit up for a moment It was pure crimson. You mean to ask me to take her so that she can avoid this? Hayashi looked ashamed for the first time in the girl's life. The Hyuga clan was powerful. They were proud. Hinata knew the members of her clan, did not tolerate weakness. But now she saw her father displaying something the elders would see as weak and unforgivable, as he collapsed down to his knees and bowed his head. "I do not ask, my lord. I beg of you," he said. "The mark has already cost me more than you can ever know. I just can't put my daughters through such a trial." As Naruto simply looked down towards the man, he could see his determination, his resolve. Nothing that he would say right now could change a man's mind. But being a seal user himself, Naruto was curious. This seal, what does it do? Hayashi raised his head, looking up towards Naruto. "It is a monstrous construct that the founding members of my clan created for weaker Byakugan users. We grew in numbers, and the branch family was feared because they were more than the main family. So the elders of the main family placed those marks on their head, limiting their Byakugan or subjecting them to great pain. And worst of all, death. If they disobey the main branch." He hung his head low. "I lost my brother to the seal, and his son was sealed when he turned 6. Once again, the eye, eerie of Naruto mask lit up. "And you condone this," he said. "No," Hayashi said quickly. "I hate the way my clan treats his fellows. I would have done away with the mark a long time ago, if I could. But the elders outvoted me every time." As Naruto glanced towards the two girls, the elder one was looking at him with the most gentlest eyes that he ever saw. As he looked at her, she was pleading with him in her own way. As for the younger one, she was afraid. She was terrified of him because of what he was. No doubt she heard rumors, talks. However, her sister, there was no fear. And he had to say that she was beautiful. He did not have much interaction with ladies, but still, she was one of the most beautiful that he's ever seen. His mind wandered to what Jiraiya was saying before he had cut him off, because he was correct about her. "What's your name?" said Naruto. "Hinata, my lord," she said. "Tell me, do you agree with this? I know you must not like this arrangement," he said to her.
"I don't know what to think," she said. "But I understand why my father want to avoid branding one of us. My clan is harsh in the way they treat the weaker members or families with more than one child. I don't want to see that happen to my sister, so I would voluntarily take the seal if I could save her," she said. "As a stance, I am weaker than she is, so I would be sealed regardless."
"And staying here," said Naruto. "I am considered a demon by many, including your clan." Hayashi watched as Hinata rose up. As she stepped towards Naruto, a bit shorter than he was, her hand slowly came up, moving with grace. As she lifted his mask, his face was round, almost having a childish look, except there was angles in the cheek, which made him look mature at the same time. And there was also 3 marks on each of his cheek as well, whisker marks. He was incredibly handsome, she thought. But his eyes, they were like rough cut sapphires. The slitted pupil made his eyes look so much more exotic, and his blonde flowing hair. Jiraiya, over to the side, looked towards her. "She's not afraid."
"You don't look like a demon to me," Hinata said. "Even if you don't take me for a wife, would you let me stay here?"
"For my little sister," she said. As Naruto was quiet for a while, until a tiny smile came on his face.
"You may stay," he said.
As Hinata and Hanabi beamed at that. "But the Hyuga clan must do something for me in return." Hayashi smiled, hearing the acceptance.
"Name it. And if it is within my power, it shall be done," Hayashi said.
As Naruto turned to face him. "Oh, it is.
I'm not the sort of person that would ask for the moon. As he stepped towards the wall where another portrait was lying. This one was a village with a castle in the background. What I need from you is aid to rebuild the ancestral village of the Whirling Tides. As he stepped towards the man, do we have a deal? He asked, his hand extending forward. Hayashi reached forward and took his hand. We have a deal, he said. Time skip. Hinata and her family were led to the rooms where they will be staying. Hayashi will be staying here to spend one night with his two girls together as a family. During dinner, the dining hall was big and grand. However, the demon lord was nowhere to be seen. Jiraiya acted like this was a normal occurrence, as he simply introduced them to the island, Whirling Tides. Hanabi was curious as she saw a strange fruit that neither of them had ever seen before. It looked like a pear, yet it was orange with swirling marks around it, and it was soft and easy to bite into. They also saw different fishes that they've never seen before. This included the main dish, a rather frightening fish that Jiraiya called the Black Dragon. It indeed looked like a painting that she had seen in the Land of Dragons. It even had horns on its head, so she was afraid to try a bite. The rest of the meal made up for it though. Most of what was there was grown on the island. Why have you not opened the trading route? Hinata asks. Most of these would be considered fit for daimyos and feudal lords. Hinata said, the food here was truly a delicacy. I did try, Lady Hinata. Jiraiya said, once, 4 or 5 years ago, I took a bundle of fruit and vegetables to the mainland. At first, they attracted a large amount of attention. But once, someone realized that they were from the Whirlpool Island. I was hard pressed to get out of that area without trying to hurt anyone to get out of there. Why would they do such a thing when these are perfectly fine? Hayashi said. It then dawned on him, but Jiraiya spoke. People will always fear demons. And they fear being tainted by the demon, so they fear everything that is corrupted by the demon. He picked up one of the fruit, such as a piece of fruit that is grown on the island that is ruled by the ninth demon lord. You know that people are calling these demon fruits. There's no demonic aura about them, said Jiraiya as he crushed the thing. Just a simple fruit. It's just as well. Seeing that my lord lives here alone, the people might try to harm him, which would not end well for them, Jiraiya thought. Hinata looked down. He must be very lonely, she said. Jiraiya glanced towards her. You speak like you felt that way, Lady Hinata, he said. I have. Looking at her father and sister. From the time I could walk, I was groomed to be the heir of the clan, expected to act, behave a certain way. And then my little sister came into the world, she said. I was so happy to have a little sibling because friendship inside or outside the clan was frowned upon. But then I learned about the cruel twist of fate that her birth brought about. One of us was to be sealed and one of us will be the next leader of the clan. I would have willingly chosen to be branded, but Hanabi was much stronger than I was at her age, so therefore, she was a better choice. Hayashi looked at her sadly. I would have found a way to spare you, he said. She looked towards him kindly. You would have been branded as a traitor, despite your title and the seal. You would have been put to death, but cruel as our family can be seen. I am happy to have you two in my life. And despite me living here now, I hope things can continue that way, she said to them. Of course it will, said Jiraiya. Naruto would not just send them away and ban them from ever returning. Far from it. As much as I fear him around normal people and ninjas, he crave human contacts. He will have you over as much as often. Where is the young lord? Hayashi said. I would have thought he would have attended dinner. He normally meditate during the evening and eat dinner later, Jiraiya said with a sigh. The meditation helped him contact with the fox. And his training as well.
You see, he's a user of senjutsu, an ancient art that called upon nature chakra from the nature itself. It takes a very long time to master, but he's excel at it.
So the Lord is also a sage, Hanabi said smiling. What else can he do?
Chiria chuckled at the child.
Well, little one, I've already told you that he's a master of the art of sealing. But he's also a wind user as well, thanks to his father. And in a way, the fox. Wind style users is rare in the Leaf Village. And Naruto came from a wind nature family. And the fox has an affinity for fire and wind as well. He's not fully able to use fire yet, but he practiced endlessly with it.
Really? Hi, she said.
That is quite a coincidence because Hinata is a wind user as well.
Jiraiya looked over a bit surprised.
That's a good thing, I think. Perhaps the shared element will get them to know each other better.
I'll try, Hinata said, a small blush in her cheeks.
Meanwhile, as Naruto sat right in front of the massive bars, two red eyes were glaring down at him.
I do not know why you persist with these stupid beatings.
You know I want nothing more than to see you suffer and die. To reclaim my freedom, the fox said, as he scratched against the bars.
The reason I keep this up is because, unlike most people, I try to see the good in everything. Even a demonic beast like you, fox.
You still have not answered my question. Why were you, the strongest of all tailed beasts, sealed away when you were freed for the longest?
Who can say, brat, he said, swishing his tails behind him. The humans were probably too afraid to approach me.
I do not believe that, said Naruto, as he got up and stepped towards the seal.
You, out of all the others I heard of, never truly attack anyone, save for the battles between Madara Uchiha and Senju Hashirama. Tell me, why did you fight then? Why did you fight alongside with humans, let alone a ninja in the first place?
As Naruto stood right at the bars, looking up at the beast, the fox growled.
You know nothing, you insignificant little insect.
Then help me understand, said Naruto. Can't you see? I wish to help you.
Help me.
You can't even help yourself, the fox said angrily.
When you still reside in that ungrateful village, who was it that always healed your wounds when the villagers would attack you? Who looked out and cared for you when no one else would?
Was it not I?
Four claws shot out, inches away from Naruto's face. However, he did not budge in the slightest.
As the fox rose up fully, you will not find it so easy with me, brat. I am not like my brethren. I am above them in all else, and you shall feel that power. You will crave it.
Red mist started to gather around Naruto, swirling and stretching around.
Do not do this, said Naruto.
Nine tails, he yelled.
That is not my name, the fox growled.
But my name is something no mortal shall ever know again.
Burn, Naruto Uzumaki. Feel my hate. Suffer, as I've suffered for thousands of years.
Visions start to flash through Naruto's mind of battles from the past. Horrible, dreadful battles. Bloody corpses all over. Screams of the dying wailing. The sound of steel clashing against steel. And the smell of blood. He was in hell.
Collapsing in the real world.
Naruto, he heard the voice.
A hand rested on his back. It was Jiraiya.
What happened, he said.
Naruto panted slightly.
The fox, he said.
He's been more malicious than normal.
As Naruto gripped the ground, his nails tearing into it.
I'm starting to believe that this is hopeless.
He's so angry. He gets angrier every time we speak.
As Jiraiya helped Naruto up to his feet.
Listen, kid, he said. I know you want to make peace with the fox, but perhaps you should cut yourself off.
Look what it's doing to you, said Jiraiya, as Naruto whisker marks had become deeper, more scar-like.
His fangs grown out as well, and his nails looked like tiny daggers.
This is only temporary, said Naruto.
You know that. Now, how are the guests doing?
Jiraiya sighed.
Before he chuckled slightly, trying to change up the mood. Worrying about your new, bouncy wife, huh?
She's not my wife, said Naruto.
Yet, said Jiraiya. Admit it, she's as attractive as the wife of a daimyo. She's a flower dropped into a mud pot and...
Alright.
She's beautiful, I get it, said Naruto.
Can you please stop talking about my...
Naruto snapped his mouth shut as Jiraiya got a big goofy grin on his face.
Don't you dare start, Pervy Sage, he said.
Do not start with your damn research.
Oh, if my hunch is right, then I don't have to.
I'll just sit back and watch the fun, Jiraiya said.
As Naruto simply sighed, are they doing well or not? I trust that dinner went alright.
Jiraiya informed him about what they spoke about, and then he got to Hinata.
She seemed openly concerned about you, kid. You might as well consider her a little bit.
Look, said Naruto, while I appreciate what you might be insinuating, I will not force a girl affection just because she thinks it's her clan duty.
This sounds like one of those cheesy sex novels that you write, said Naruto.
Oho, said Jiraiya. So you have been reading my work.
Oh, shut it, said Naruto.
Never, said Jiraiya.
As they made their way down the halls.
But Naruto, what are you gonna do?
I mean, what if the new shrine is not enough to appease the foxes?
I suppose I'll have to visit them, much as I think that's a bad idea. But I can't think of anything else that would might work.
Jiraiya sighed as they turned the corner. Are you sure you want to go back there again?
As they recall the day when they left, we didn't exactly make a lot of friends when we were there.
As Naruto shrugged also, recalling the event.
10 years ago when Naruto was about to enter his life of solitude, the villagers decided to give him a send-off. Not a good one at all. If Jiraiya had not shown up in time, the fox would have been released once again.
Naruto wounds were bad, despite him being a Jinjuriki.
While they were not fatal because of that, his wounds were still bad.
Jiraiya had lost it,
which led to his exile with Naruto.
I know we didn't, said Naruto.
All the more reason for us to go back.
Besides, you know, I can't just leave the innocents helpless if I can do something about it.
And not all were bad, said Naruto.
But despite all of that, said Naruto, as he looked down toward his hands.
I am Naruto Uzumaki, the demon lord of the Whirling Island. I'm supposed to be this, and look like a monster, aren't I?
Jiraiya sighed as he ran a hand down his face.
You're supposed to be a normal, happy boy, at the age of 16.
I'm just sorry I could not give that to you.
You've been good to me, Jiraiya, said Naruto.
I couldn't ask for a better father, not even my real one.
He was better than me, Jiraiya said, as he patted the kid on the shoulder, as he said goodnight.
Try not to scare the guests, okay?
No promises, said Naruto, as he went into his chambers.
Time skip, Hinata
slept close to her sister. Her father was on the other side. However, she woke up late in the night. Something woke her up. However, everything seemed fine. But she felt something though, coming from down the hall. As she got up, feeling the sensation to see what it was. As she slid the door open, her steps were soft and careful as she made her way down the hall. It was leading her towards her lord's room. The door was painted with the snarling face of a fox, parted down the center when it opened. With her byakkan, she could see that he was even the one thrashing on the inside. Something was wrong. As she went inside, My lord, she said. She hurried to him as she careful not to trip.
My lord, are you alright, she said.
But he was still stuck in this strange sleep.
My lord, it's me, he...
She was cut off in one swift movement. She found herself against the wall.
He was so fast as she hit said wall.
She fell down.
as he stood over her. His eyes, the look on his face, something was wrong. Naruto, she said, trying to snap him out of this trance as he slowly stepped towards her. He then blinked. Hinata? He said. His eyes were pure crimson, red, like blood. As they slowly returned back to their blue color, he shook his head. What are you? You were in pain, so I came to check to see if I could help you, she said to him. Get into your feet. You don't need to worry, said Naruto as he turned his back. It was just a nightmare. It happened often. I'm sorry I scared you, he said. I didn't hurt you, did I? As he turned towards her. I'm fine, she said. But I'm worried about you, my Naruto, he said. Just Naruto. I've never been one for titles. As you wish, she said to him. That is when she realized that he was bare-chested. As she was able to see his upper body, she snapped her eyes away. I'm sorry, she said, for coming into your room unannounced. But she was nervous now, given the situation. As Naruto looked down and realized why she was acting that way, he picked up his robe and placed it on. You came at the perfect time, he said. Normally, my dreams haunt me, and I'm stuck in them until the very end. However, you brought me out, he said. You have my thanks. Hearing him thank her felt little heats stir to her cheeks as they got slightly red. The place was dark, so not much could be seen. If I may ask, what was your nightmare? She said, stepping forward towards the balcony. She followed after him. She was shocked. The view was simply magnificent, in all the sense of the word, absolutely stunning. As he spoke, looking over the village, my dreams change from night to night. Often, I see my life in the village. Those people wishing me dead, seeing me as an ideal fox. Sometime I would see through the eyes of the fox itself, witnessing battles after battles, since the dawn of the ninja world. Those are the worst of the dreams. All those people fighting, suffering, and dying for no reason. It makes me sick. And so you came here, Hinata mumbled. As she watched the clouds pass above, my childhood in the village, though not as harsh as yours, was not easy, she said. As she tried to understand him, she stood right beside him as she glanced over, watching as he did. When I was small, a man from the village known as Kumo tried to steal me away. My father stopped and killed him, but the Raikage blamed us for killing his ambassador and demanded that my father be killed for his crimes. As Naruto looked towards her, but he's still here. I'm assuming that they were able to sort it out. Not in a happy way, she said. My father had a twin brother, identical twin. Uncle Hizashi volunteered his own life in my father's place. With a mark on his forehead, there was no worry about the eyes being taken. And he died, she said. The elders believed that it was the only way. My father never wanted to go through with it, to have his brother be sacrificed. However, everything was against him. Hinata heard a sound as she watched the balcony creak. He was holding on to metal, and yet it was making strange sounds. Naruto, she said. Forgive me, said Naruto. I hate that people can determine the life of a member just because they're the elders of a clan, especially for reasons that should not be as easy as to take one's life. As he started to squeeze so hard, however, she held onto his hand. Stop. You'll ruin your hands. He glanced towards her surprise. She was worried about his hands, the minuscule injury that would not last in the slightest. She took his hands as she slowly rubbed her hands over it, releasing any pain that would have been there. But the mark was gone within a second. It just showed the amount of force that he used. He was examining her hands as she held his. You were raised to fight all of your life, and yet your hands are so gentle, so warm, so soft. Hinata blushed as she looked up at him. You should probably go back to your room, he said. What if your family wakes up and worry? Yes, she said. I should go back. I'll see you in the morning, she said to him. He nodded as she made her way off. As Naruto wondered if that was also a dream. No. His dreams had never been so kind to him before. So this was indeed reality. Hours later, Hinata woke up in her own bed after her encounter with the Lord. Remembering what he said about her hands, she laid back against the pillow, sighing in content. It was a bit good to wake up late on occasion, she thought to herself. Things were different now. She was no longer at the hidden leaf. Now she was here. A different life. Yes, she still had the people that she cared about. However, there were some new people that would be entering her life. The Lord, no. He said to call him Naruto. And she liked that. It made her happy. As much as she loved staying with her father and sister, she felt happy here. As she wondered how would the future turn out for her and Naruto. She was not sure. Only time will tell. And she was right. Only time will tell. Peace is never everlasting in this world. Chaos must always reign after a while. Certain forces always bring up the worst in people. Always force people to make moves that they did not want to make. However, for now, it was calm, peaceful. And that was okay. But not for long. But guys, be in subscribe right here. If you want to see next person do, like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. Remember, share to all of your friends in your social media platform. And don't forget to go ahead and check out the other channels. Yes, indeed, a four of them, guys. Anime King, Anime King 2, 3, and also Symbol, guys. So without further ado, let's begin this now. What am I saying? Let's get the hell out of here. Peace.